Hi, my name is Ido Vitman Zilber. I'm a high school student working with RavenDB to show you how to build your app's backend with a document database. In this video series, we will use a simple Next.js app to learn about two document databases, RavenDB and MongoDB. We will explore querying, bulk insert, pagination, full text search, and more. I have no prior experience with either product, and the only source of information I have for both databases is the available content online and what I managed to figure out on my own. The project has three parts: the front-end, a Next.js website, a backend with RavenDB, and a backend with MongoDB. I will quickly go over the Next.js app as this is not the focus of this video. As you can see, the website is very simple. There is an input for searching the users by first name, a timer that measures how much time the query took, and a table for displaying the users. Now, let's learn how the website works behind the scenes. In the RavenDB studio, the documents are grouped by collections. In this project, there is a user collection of 10 users. Each user has a first and last name and objects for address, contact, and job info. To interact with the database, I set up a simple Express API. The user's endpoint calls the getUsers function, which I will show you later, then it sends the result to the website. In the client.ts file, I first create a document store that will serve as my connection to the database. Make sure you only create one instance of the document store. Because RavenDB is safe by default, I use a certificate, which I easily generated in the RavenDB studio. Then, I define the getUsers function that takes a query, a field to sort by, and a boolean representing the order of the sort as arguments. In order to query the database, I first open a session and then define a query on the user's collection. Next, I sort the query, and if the query string is not empty, filter the users by their first name. Then, I execute the query and return the result. Finally, I measure how much time the query takes. Now, let's do the same with MongoDB. MongoDB also has a studio called Campus. Here we can see the users collection with 10 users, just like in the RavenDB studio. The Express API is exactly the same in the MongoDB code, so we can skip right to the client.ts file. I first create a reference to the users collection, then I define the getUsers function that you are already familiar with. In the function, I create a query and filter the users by their first name. Note that I couldn't find a built-in function to find users whose first name field starts with the query, so I'm using a regular expression for that. Next, I sort the users, execute the query, and return the results, and finally measure how much time the query takes. To sum up what we learned in this video, we have built the foundations of the project, creating a simple API to use RavenDB and MongoDB. Then, we looked at the basics of querying a document database. There was no difference between the databases performance-wise, nor do we expect a difference, given that we only work with 10 users in each database. In the next video, we will make this project a little bit more realistic by replacing the 10 users we currently have in each database with 10 million users, as most real-world applications need to handle.